الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله على آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. First I'd like to make the dua that Allah accept from those who are doing the i'tikaf, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept those who spend the night for his sake subhanahu wa ta'ala and tahajjud, and that Allah accept our fasting and our qiyam and our ibadah, and that Allah azza wa jal make us reach the end of Ramadan while we are forgiven and we are all pardoned from his punishment and admitted to his mercy subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma amin. Second, following up on the etiquettes of the masjid, the line is very important. You just got feedback that the line, the last line was not straight, so inshallah that dark line on the salah, you put your heels on it, not your toes. So if you put your toes and somebody putting their heels, the line will not be straight. So inshallah you make sure inshallah the line is straight inshallah. Next time put your heels inshallah on the line and make sure it's aligned, your shoulder and your knees and your ankles, that are aligned with the one beside you from both sides inshallah rabbil alamin. The ayah of today we recited a couple of days ago in the Taraweeh, in Surah Ash-Shura. وَلَوْ بَسَطَ اللَّهُ الرِّزْقَ لِعِبَادِهِ لَبَغَوْا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَكِنْ يُنَزِّلُ بِقَدْرٍ مَّا يَشَاءُ إِنَّهُ بِعِبَادِهِ خَبِيرٌ بَصِيرٌ إِنَّهُ بِعِبَادِهِ خَبِيرٌ بَصِيرٌ. Allah عز وجل said, if Allah extends rizq to his servants, they would surely transgress on this earth. Surely transgress on this earth. طب اقفلوا الباب يا اخوان. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if he extends the rizq to his servants, they would surely transgress on earth. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ينزل, make the rizq descends, بقدر ما يشاء. يعني according to his will, certain measurement to certain people at certain time, certain way. That's biqadar, yani. Biqadar means certain risk, certain amount to certain person in a certain way, in a certain time frame. هذا يعني ينزل بقدر ما يشاء. Why? إنه بعباده, truly Allah with his servants, خبير بصير. خبير is expert, خبرة يعني. خبير. Allah عز وجل is خبير, فاسأل به خبيرة. يعني خبير means aware. Allah is knowledgeable with all related issues to that topic. That's khabir. So when you say this person is khabir in medicine, this person khabir is in engineering, this person khabir in that game, this person khabir in this affair or this strategy, he's khabir. Khabir means expert. So inna Allah bi'ibadihi khabir basir. طبعاً بصر, our بصر different. طبعاً الله عز وجل له بصر سبحانه وتعالى يليق بكماله سبحانه وتعالى, perfect way to see سبحانه وتعالى. So Allah عز وجل is watching. So Allah is aware and Allah is watching over. These two characteristics very important when you are dealing with رب العالمين, because sometimes when you don't get what you like or what you want, you feel that you are transgressed, or you feel that you deserve better, right? You deserve better. This is a human feeling. But that's when we deal with each other. Why? I am short. I am not perfect. I'm imperfect, and you are imperfect. Yeah? So if I'm expecting something from you and I don't get, I always have this hard feeling. Why? Because you're an imperfect being like me. How come you forget? So you are accused here. And if I don't give you something you're expecting, you feel the same, right? You feel the same. Why he did not give me the attention? Why when I entered, he looked at me and he did not say salam? Why these kind of things? Because we account each other like that. But when we deal with Allah, be careful. When you deal with Allah Azza wa Jal, you should be extra careful. Actually, be super careful. Be careful at all, yani. All the time. Be careful the maximum way. So you don't accuse Allah Azza wa Jal with this. If you don't get, it's not yours. If you get, it's yours. ما أخطأك لم يكن ليصيبك. صح؟ وما أصابك يعني إيه هذا الكلام؟ What does that mean؟ يعني when رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said whatever missed you is not yours and whatever comes to you there is no way nobody else would take it. It is yours. So when you have that aqeedah, Allah is khabir and the basir, خلاص, you know, Allah knows what is best for me and Allah. So I will do everything in my capacity within the limits of Allah. And Allah Azza wa Jalla is the one who decides. So you don't say that, so what is the point anyways? If Allah gives me, what's the point? No, the point is you have. He told you also to do. You know, this qadr issue always comes up. Right? Always comes up. So what's the point? No, the point is two things. Allah told you whatever you get is yours, whatever you don't get is not yours, but don't sit still. So He is the same one who told you to do both. So don't use qadr against Allah. Don't use the qadr of Allah against the shara of Allah. You get the idea here? So there is qadr of Allah, there is the sharia of Allah. It's the same Allah. He told you, I know everything and it's already decided, but you have to do this and not to do this. It's the same one. So don't use this side against this side for the same one. How? Okay? So He's Allah Azza wa Jalla. He told you, I know everything. I decided everything already. There is no matter what you do, it's already decided. So don't say, what is the point? The point is the same one told you, halal and haram, pray, do this, do that. So do this and ask Him, Ya Allah, make me among the ones you write in Jannah, not the ones you write in Hellfire. Because you already know. Alright? So Allah Azza wa Jalla says, if He extends the rizq to everybody, people would transgress. The reason of the revelation of this ayah, there was people, Sahaba, poor ones, poor. And they're Ahl al-Suffa. They had like a little raised area in the masjid of the Prophet ﷺ. They sit and sleep and eat, and people give them, you know, sadaqah, and they eat and they study. They are there because they don't have any, you know, capital or anything. But subhanallah, Allah make taqdeer for them that they become poor, so they carry the sunnah of Rasulullah ﷺ. And you see the goodness of that is us now. Abu Huraira has to be Abu Huraira to carry this. Imagine kida, Abu Huraira is having business and millionaire kida, like Abdurrahman ibn Auf. Yani. Khalas. Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf is Abd al-Rahman ibn Auf, right? He donated and he did all of what he did. But how many hadith he narrated? Few. Two, three, four. Abu Huraira, one third of the sunnah. 6,000 something hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At their time, some of them wished to have wealth. فنزلت الآية دي. يعني this ayah was revealed because some of Ahl al-Suffa, they felt the tightness of, you know, Ma'isha is like stuff, you know, tight. All these Sahaba, they are going and market and all of this. Sahaba of Rasulullah, they have money and families. وَحْنَا عَدِينَ كِدَا مَسْجِدٍ, you know, sitting in the masjid, tight. لَوْ أَنَّ لَنَا هَذَا وَلَوْ أَنَّ لَنَا ذَاكَ. Khabbab ibn al-Arat said that ayah is revealed about us, Ahl al-Suffa, because some of us wished to have some of the dunya that others had. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, if Allah extends for people, that they will transgress. So some people, Allah knows that their salah is to stay poor. Some, their salah is to stay rich. And some Allah Azza wa Jalla make poor to test them and they fail. Some Allah make rich to test them and they succeed. Who knows? So it goes both ways, as I explained before. So everything is basically, you have to ask Allah to make it as means to reach Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether you are sick or healthy, rich or poor, knowledgeable or not, ask Allah to use you to reach Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the main concern of the believer. So Allah said, if He extends, people baghaw. You know, baghi means dhulm extra, yani extra dhulm, extra transgression. Means passing all the limits and etiquettes and everything, baghaw fil ard. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal gives the rizq according to each one. One of my shaykh, he said one time something nice. He says, if Allah Azza wa Jal, maybe you ask Allah to give you $1 million and Allah responds to you. Maybe He gives you $1 million, but on payments, yani. In payments. He gives you $1 million. You know, a child who makes 100,000 a year, you know, something like that for 10 years. Or, you know, he gives you a car here, or this here, or that here. Or he saves you from something that you would have spent $1 million. يعني he gives you $1 million, and then you get sick, you spend $1 million. So you don't get sick, and you don't get $1 million, you got $1 million. Something like that. Yeah. But we don't calculate it like this. We don't calculate it like that. We always calculate it in, I need $1 million kida cash, like this. I was, okay, 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, that's how I want it. Right? But we don't see how many millions. انظر, كم أنفق الله منذ خلق السماوات والأرض. On me and you. How much did Allah Azza wa Jalla spend on us? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see someone who is not healthy, how much they spend to become healthy. That's how much you have. Think about it like that. Right? You walk, you stand up now, and you will walk outside the masjid. You go to your car, to the parking lot, mashallah. Someone, subhanallah, who does not have that ability to walk. How much effort, how much technology, and how much money get them to go with ease from here to the parking lot? How much does it cost the masjid to make a ramp for someone? You see? And they just walk. You wake up in the morning, you put your feet down, and you go to the bathroom. How many people, subhanallah, on their bed at the hospital, how much they spend, how many people are employed to help that person just go to qada al-haja, to the restroom, a'azakumullah, yeah. See how much you have? You want me to keep going on and on and on? Someone who lost their eyes. How much can they spend to get their eyes back, to see their own children, subhanallah, every day? Their own children. Hey, how are you doing? And all of that. One time somebody sent me a small clip, like a little child who's like a few months old or a year old or something like that, who have problem with their eyesight. And then they put the glasses for the first time on that baby, and he looks at his mom and he laughs. Big smile, and make everybody around them cry. How much this is worth? You take your children for granted. You take your life for granted. You wake up in the morning and look around. And our children holding the iPad all day and the phone all day and watching the TV all day. With this ni'mah is how much? You ask Allah for $1 million? How much is this? How much is this? How much walking? How much drinking and filling your stomach? How much all that? You see, how much Allah spend on you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, without asking you for anything except to worship Him and say subhanallah. So you understand, my ikhwani? You understand, my brothers? وَلَوْ بَسَطَ اللَّهُ الرِّزْقَ لِعِبَادِهِ لَبَغَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ. This money comes, is just means. But you already walking wealth. This is wealth. Millions and millions and millions and millions, literally, wallahi. Literally. And you know all these millions, where it's gonna go? Dirt. The dirt. So use these millions Allah give you of investment. So when you go to the dirt, there is a'mal which worth billions. That's what will continue after you, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, until we reach Al-Jannah, inshallah. So this is a lesson I hope I delivered, inshallah. So always, whatever you have, always think you are rich in that sense. But you are always faqir to Allah. You're always faqir, needy to Allah, but you are wealthy. Wallahi, you are rich. We are all rich, subhanallah. And whatever means Allah give us, inshallah, we complete each other as a jama'ah bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who listen and follow the best of what they listen to. Wa salli Allahumma wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.